of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
A hearty welcome to this Eucharist, my dear brothers and sisters. Today we are celebrating the feast of St. John the Baptist. Normally it's on the 24th of June. Today, this year, it's one day earlier, because on the 24th, tomorrow, we're celebrating the Feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. It takes priority, and so this feast is anticipated to today. Happy feast to all the Baptists, to all the Joans or Johns who are called after St. John the Baptist. We begin the sacrifice on the feast of this great saint, the precursor of Jesus, pointing to Jesus, the preparation for Jesus, by putting ourselves in God's presence, asking his forgiveness for our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us now praise God in the words of the Gloria.
Amen.
O God, who raised up St. John the Baptist to make ready a nation fit for Christ the Lord, give your people, we pray, the grace of spiritual joys, and direct the hearts of all the faithful into the way of salvation and peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly sit for the readings.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Listen to me, O coastlands, and give attention, you peoples from afar. The Lord called me from the womb, from the body of my mother, he called my name. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified." But I said, "I have labored in vain, I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity. Yet surely my right is with the Lord, and my recompense with my God." And now the Lord said, "He who formed me from the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him, for I am honored in the eyes of the Lord, and my God has become my strength." He says, "It is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to bring back the preserved of Israel. I will make you as a light for the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response will be, "I thank you who wonderfully made me." Kindly repeat.
I thank you who wonderfully made me.
O Lord, you search me and you know me. You yourself know my resting and my rising. You discern my thoughts from afar. You mark when I walk or lie down. You know all my ways through and through. Our response,
I thank you who wonderfully made me.
For it was you who formed my innermost being, knit me together in my mother's womb. I thank you who wonderfully made me, how wonderful are your works, which my soul knows well. Our response,
I thank you who wonderfully made me.
My frame was not hidden from you when I was being fashioned in secret and molded in the depths of the earth. Our response,
I thank you who wonderfully made me.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Paul said, "God raised up David to be their king, of whom he testified and said, 'I have found in David, the son of Jesse, a man after my heart, who will do all my will.' Of this man's offspring, God has brought to Israel a Savior, Jesus, as he had promised. Before his coming, John had proclaimed a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was finishing his course, he said, 'What do you suppose that I am? I am not he. No, but behold, after me one is coming, the sandal of whose feet I am not worthy to untie. Brothers, sons of the family of Abraham, of those among you who fear God, to us has been sent the message of this salvation.'" the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. You child will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now the time came for Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. And her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they would have called him Zechariah after his father, but his mother answered, "No, he shall be called John." And they said to her, "None of her relatives is called by this name." And they made signs to his father, inquiring what he wanted him to be called. And he asked for a writing tablet, and he wrote, "His name is John." And they all wondered. And immediately his mouth was opened, his tongue loosed, and he spoke, blessing God. Fear came on all their neighbors, and all these things were talked about throughout the hill country of Judea. And all who heard them laid them up in their hearts, saying, "What then will this child be? For the hand of the Lord was with him." The child grew up, became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until the day of his public appearance to Israel. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My sisters and brothers, this is the very big feast, the solemnity of St. John the Baptist. We celebrate just three birthdays in the liturgical calendar of the year. The birthday naturally of Jesus on Christmas, the birthday of Our Lady, September 8th, Nativity of Our Lady, and John the Baptist on the 24th. But however big the feast is, yet it naturally has got to give way for a bigger feast, the Sacred Heart of Jesus, which we celebrate tomorrow. So 23rd today is John the Baptist. And John the Baptist was the precursor of the Lord, the one who was chosen to go and prepare the immediate preparation for the coming of Jesus. The whole of the Old Testament, we've been hearing the Old Testament, the Book of Kings now recently, in between we heard the Chronicles for a short time, but all that is preparation, everything is just leading up to the protection of the country Israel, then the people, and finally Jesus himself, the precursor. The precursor pronounces him, Jesus himself comes. And so the precursor means one before, one who announces. Now John is like the separation. He ends the Old Testament and now the New Testament begins. He is the greatest, Jesus says, of those born of him. Jesus gives him great credit and great praise. He was the relative of Jesus. We know that his birth was announced. We know the extraordinary circumstances in which Zechariah was told that he would bear a child. It was God working very extraordinarily, because they were both advanced in age, both Zechariah and Elizabeth. But because of the special mission that he had. Now Jesus, when the angel Gabriel announced to Our Lady that Jesus was going to be born, and to reinforce, to strengthen her faith, he told her, "Your kinswoman, advanced in age, is also going to bear a child, and it's already the sixth month." And remember that Our Lady Mary rushed to help Elizabeth. And so even to Our Lady, the birth of John the Baptist was announced. John the Baptist, there's so much we can learn from him. He was humble. He knew he was only preparing the way for Jesus. People, he had great followers. As a matter of fact, he was very popular for his austere way of living. He only wore camel's shirt, ate locusts and honey, we hear in other parts of the scriptures, and fasted over there. The kingdom of God is coming. And yet, in spite of it, he says, I am not the one who is to come. I am unfit to tie the sandals, tie the laces of the sandals of the Messiah who is to come. When Jesus came, behold the Lamb of God, he said. Then he again said, I saw the dove resting on him, and he is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit. A man full of humility, a man full of simplicity of life, but courage and commitment. He went to Herod and told him, it was not right to you to take your brother's wife. He knew that he was admired by people, respected by Herod, but he did not have the hesitation to go and tell him. He knew it would result finally, as it did, in his death. He was a man of commitment to the mission that God gave him. He only preached the coming of Jesus. We pray to John the Baptist to help us to be true disciples of Jesus. We pray to John the Baptist to help us by our life, your life and my life, to point to Jesus, that Jesus' gospel should be seen in our lives. His love, his peace, compassion, gentleness, Jesus should be seen in our lives. That's what John the Baptist did, told everybody, this is Jesus, prepared. And when the time came for him to go, he unhesitatingly went away, went into prison, finally was executed, made the way for Jesus to begin his ministry. We see the clear hand of God in all this. The Old Testament, Israel being brought from Egypt to the Holy Land, now the coming of John the Baptist. That's why the readings also point to God's preparation, God's inspiring already in his mother's womb. Already in his mother's womb, as we know, he leapt for joy when Mary came. That's what Elizabeth said. How the mother of my Lord is coming to me, my baby leapt in my womb when you came. So we have John the Baptist announcing Jesus already even before his birth. Pray to John the Baptist to help us to be like him, always pointing to Jesus. God bless you. John the Baptist was an important person in the whole of the mystery of salvation. And so today we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. Was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of body, and life everlasting. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, through goodness for this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, your goodness of this wine which we offer you, fruit of the wine and work of human hands, become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to be pleased, receive the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my sins, cleanse me from my iniquity. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our Father in heaven.
May the Lord accept a sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We place these offerings on your altar, O Lord, to celebrate with fitting honor the nativity of him who both foretold the coming of the world Savior and pointed him out when he came. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In his precursor, St. John the Baptist, we praise your great glory, for you consecrated him for a singular honor among those born of women. His birth brought great rejoicing. Even in the womb, he leapt for joy at the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the Lamb of Redemption. And to make holy the flowing waters, he baptized the very author of baptism and was privileged to bear him supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. So with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth. Before your majesty without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John the Baptist, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life. Praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, to you, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, be all glory and honor forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence the Father in the words Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we be always free from sin and safe from all distress. We wait the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, say to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Having feasted at the banquet of the heavenly Lamb, we pray, O Lord, that finding joy in the Nativity of St. John the Baptist, your church may know as the author of a rebirth, the Christ whose coming John foretold. Make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The mighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass end, let's go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
God bless each one of you. Once again, happy feast to John the Baptist, Bautist and Baptist and whatever your name is. John's also. We pray for each other. Pray John the Baptist to help us to be true witnesses of Christ. See you tomorrow, Feast of Sacred Heart. I'll be with you.